Hey man, no, I'm sorry, I'm getting ready for a mariachi gig. Mariachi gig. No. No, dude, a mariachi gig.
You have a gig at a calamari place. No, Ryan, that's not what he's saying.
Thank you, John. Appreciate it, man.
He's saying he has a gig in Montanari. I didn't say that already? No, dude, your ears haven't been working that well. Hey, my ears are perfectly fine.
El tiempo pasa.
Hello everyone, Isaiah Herrera here from the El Paso Society for Musicians of the Future. Today is a very special day because we are finally diving into the rich history of Mexican music, more specifically, mariachi music. Mariachi music is that music your grandparents listened to, and for good reasons. Mariachi music is amongst one of the most expressive and beautiful forms of music in the entire world, and to most, it is the best representation of their culture. It is important to note, though, that before we get into the history of mariachi music, there is a lot of undocumented information of its early history, so we did our best to gather the most precise and consistent information. Without further ado, join Ryan Esparza, John Esparza, and myself as we take you through the great history of mariachi music.
Let us begin with the origin of mariachi music. Mariachi music can date back to the early 1500s when Hernán Cortés landed in what is now Mexico. The musicians in his company would play the violin, guitar, harps, woodwind, and brass instruments, which are some of the early predecessors to the instruments in modern mariachi. The natives in that land quickly mastered the musical practice of the Europeans. And with a large number of African American slaves being imported to the land, there was a blend of music amongst the groups. This resulted in the rise of early mestizo folk music, which blends elements of foreign and indigenous music, as well as culture. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the origin of mariachi music.
Now, mariachi music developed differently in each region of Mexico, but the sound of this music as we all know today can be drawn back to the state of Jalisco, Mexico, in the 19th century. As a quick note, the word mariachi is said to have come from the French word mariage, meaning marriage, though this is still debated amongst historians. If this theory is true, it is due to the fact that the mariachis during this time would play at rural parties, which were fiestas, where couples would dance sones and jarabes. With that said, it is important to know that mariachi music was originally dance music, with styles that include the zapateado and the jarabe.
The dance technique of the zapateado originated from Spain. However, it is associated with two rhythmic styles of music, which are the son jalisciense and the son jarocho. When dancing the zapateado, the performers would use the heels of their boots to drive them into the ground, creating a loud thump sound, often in sync with the rhythm of the instruments. With the jarabe, both the male and female dancers would wear very distinct costumes and perform different variations of dance music, which include sones, danzas, jotas, and polkas. The most prominent, however, was the jarabe tapatío, or the Mexican hat dance. Before the Mexican Revolution of 1910, mariachi music was almost unknown, and musicians would perform in the rural regions of Mexico for small celebrations, weddings, and so on. As a matter of fact, mariachis during the revolution would travel from town to town, singing and playing songs about the battle, proving to be a huge role in how news got to different regions in Mexico. Their attire wasn't very presentable though, as the musicians would wear whatever clothes they had in a casual way. Following the end of the revolution, however, mariachi groups began to dress in more uniform clothing that was highly presentable. And this was the birth of the traje de charro, or suit of the horseman, in the 1930s. These suits consisted of tight pants, a short jacket, a large sombrero, short riding boots, and a large belt that gave them an elegant look.
In addition to the end of the Mexican Revolution, mariachi music became more accepted and praised throughout Mexico, at which point it became more urban than rural music. With this came the development of the standard mariachi instrumentation, where the quantity of the group grew, making it much louder and powerful. A standard group now contained one guitarrón, one vihuela, one guitar, three more violins, and a trumpet, with the harp being an optional instrument, as it was essentially replaced by the guitarrón and the vihuela. Quick note on the trumpet, some mariachi groups before the 1920s used a cornet, but it was replaced with the trumpet in the 1930s and became an essential instrument to the mariachi around the 1950s.
Mariachi music became even more popular when the group Mariachi Vargas de Tecalitlan, founded by Gaspar Vargas in 1898 within Tecalitlan, Jalisco, moved to Mexico City in 1934 under the leadership of Silvestre Vargas. Silvestre Vargas then hired trained musician Ruben Fuentes as the director, and together they led the group to becoming the driving popularity of mariachi music and created an ensemble that cannot be matched to this day. Because both Silvestre Vargas and Ruben Fuentes insisted on performing music that was written out, their compositions eventually got into the hands of other popular groups and or singers, which include Pedro Infante, Lola Beltran, Javier Solís, José Alfredo Jiménez, and many others. These singers with their respective groups continued to enhance the spirit of mariachi music and created new songs to enhance the mariachi repertoire.
Speaking of new music, it is worth mentioning that mariachi music is played in many different styles, similar to jazz. With mariachi, the most common styles include the vals, the bolero, the son, the bopango, and the polka. All of these styles are played and sung to accompany dancers, but mariachi groups do perform songs in any of these styles alone for gigs and or general performances. Here's an example of each style.
Mariachi music didn't just stay in Mexico, though. During the 1950s and 1960s, many mariachi groups immigrated to the United States, concentrating mostly in Los Angeles. There, a man named Nati Cano organized a group named Los Camperos in 1961, which became the leading group in the United States among non-Hispanics. Los Camperos then opened a restaurant named La Fonda in Los Angeles that became the first venue in the world to showcase a mariachi. This was eventually adapted in Mexico after other US mariachi groups did the same. Mariachi music also made its way into the world of education when the mariachi group Uglatlan, founded in 1961 at the University of California at Los Angeles Institute of Ethnomusicology, started the academics in mariachi tradition. Because of this, many educational institutions across the United States, from college to high school, began to offer education in the traditions of mariachi music. Even countries around the world started to see a rise in mariachi groups, from the United States to Japan. As you can clearly see, the mariachi music successfully made its way from a small, rural, dismissive form of music to a largely celebrated and taught form of music that has become the representation of Mexican culture throughout the world.
Whoa, quite a bit of history, huh? It's amazing how this genre of music grew from almost nothing to something that represents a form of life all on its own. Mariachi music holds a special place in the hearts of many because of how expressive it is. Love, joy, sadness, anger, battle, it's all there. And I think everybody can find something to love in this genre of music. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you all so much for joining us on the rich history of mariachi music. We hope that you gained a deeper insight as to why mariachi is so important to the world of music. Be sure to share, stay safe, and never stop learning. We will see you next time. Y esos charros que traen sombrero ancho.